As a person who practices in the field, I get enthusiastic about anything that makes my work easier and improves my results. For example, the new Orthocryl Lamination Resin 8020 Pro. This is my favorite when I want to fabricate components, especially those with a low proportion of resin. The difference compared to previous lamination resins? It's really quite simple. 8020 Pro is not as viscous. This lower viscosity offers clear advantages. The resin can penetrate faster and therefore displaces the air in the reinforcement much more effectively. This is a big plus for the quality of the finished component. It turns out much stronger without air pockets. I experience this benefit daily in practice. Let's just go through it. I personally prefer a double layer of Perlon stockinette as the final layer over the reinforcement. Now I pull a soaked PVA bag over the plaster model and apply an initial vacuum. The next step, show your colors. I mix the chosen color paste into the resin. This too is easier since the paste mixes far more readily compared to more viscous resins. Naturally, the same applies to the hardener powder. Then, the lamination process can begin. Here you need to have a feel for the process. Laminating the socket works best when the resin is absorbed by the reinforcement gradually. This allows the 8020 Pro to displace the remaining air most effectively. By carefully working it in, I ensure that any air bubbles escape and I obtain a component with a low proportion of resin. The old rule of thumb applies. The less air remains trapped in the resin, the stronger the component will be. When colleagues ask me, why do you like 8020 Pro so much? I just show them the results of my work as an answer. Sockets with surprisingly thin walls, and nevertheless, as strong as those made with more viscous resin. This is exactly what I consider the highest quality in the workshop.